Hello everyone, welcome to the SGP Annual Research Update 2022. My name is Fang Gang. This video is a part of our Tunnel Look Ahead video series. Here, I will introduce using distributed acoustic sensing to monitor underground tunnels. During the past 1 year, we cooperated with LTA, CITG, and Nishimatsu to install a dust system in a MRT tunnel construction site in Singapore. The tunnel was excavated and constructed with an earth pressure balance TBM, operating at the pressurized model for both soil and rock environment. The dust interrogator is placed in the site office and plugged in with a piece of backup communication fiber cable, connecting the site office with the underground TBM control room. The 950-meter sensing cable is then connected from the control room and tapped to the tunnel wall. The sensing fiber cable extends as the TBM moves forward. The TBM tunneling is operated ring by ring. Construction of one ring includes two stages. Mining stage. The cut head is driven by motors to break the soil and the rock. Rebuilding stage. The cut head stops while the TBM assembles the segments into a complete ring. The figure shows the time frequency spectrogram of the average recordings from a 150-meter length fiber. The first half hour is the mining stage, followed by the ring building stage. Obviously, there is a significant increase in noise energy at the low frequency band between 0 and 100 Hz when TBM is mining. The high frequency energies, above 125 Hz, show up during both stages, are likely the machinery noise constant throughout the construction. The energy excited by the TBM cutter during the mining stage propagates forward and backward as seismic waves along the tunnel. We propose to take advantage of the dust system to monitor the seismic waves to investigate the underground geological conditions. We apply seismic interferometry to the mining data to obtain the virtual shock gather. Let's see what's the information we can get from the gather. The first arrival with a velocity of 2,100 m/s could be the shear wave primarily propagating in the tunnel lining. The strong event with a velocity of 176 m/s could be the surface wave sampling both the tunnel lining and the soil behind. Due to the influence of the sediment lining, the measured surface wave velocity could be higher than the shear wave velocity of the rock and the soil around the tunnel. Additionally, the shock gather shows another event with the same velocity as the blue one, but appears 100 milliseconds later. It could be the reflection from an obstruction in front of the TBM. Using the travel time information, we can locate the unforeseen obstruction. So the figure shows rich information in dust recordings for earth property monitoring around and in front of the tunnel. Okay, that's all for this video. We acknowledge LTA and Cambridge Sensing for all the support during the project. If you have any question, please feel free to contact me. You can find more about our research on the SGP website, YouTube, and Bilibili channels.